Let's reduce some contact with the test. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Roger, Hawaii, read you loud and clear also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, end of test.
Okay, we checked all four systems, and there you go on modulation, all four, and keying with a go.
Roger, you're loud and clear here also.
You know what we found out is estimating versus having the coordinates is a hell of a lot of two different things. They're all at the place and I'm still wandering around trying to find it. And you know, I did get directions that was south of that point, and it wasn't south, it was north. So, but then that's still my fault. I've got a system. I've got a GPS. I didn't set it because I knew John had his, but there he is. I finally found it. So now we're going to wander in here and get where we need to be. So now we're going to go along this ridge and come up on it. And we'll get a shot from this side over here. So what's my suggestion? You get a GPS and use it. I mean, I kind of like to do it the old school way, but you know what? I exerted a lot of energy that I didn't need to. So across here, look at this place. Look how incredible this is. Look at all this. Look at this down here. I don't know if we're gonna find any petroglyphs along this ridge or not. We're definitely gonna try to take a look. Look at that massive structure down there below. How incredible is that? That'd be a hell of a climb. You know, I wonder if they had, they definitely had a route down here. They definitely got down in here. This was not something that they didn't use. So there would be a route that they would have taken. It looks like it curves down and through. And how incredible is that? So let's go take a look at this ruin that we've been waiting 6 months to come see and see what's really there and what it's about, which is pretty unbelievable. Now right there was where I'd estimate that they would have taken the trail that would have taken them down to the river right there. So if I was over there, I saw that trail kind of fade through. I want to keep my eyes peeled for any petroglyphs that might be down there, because they definitely possibly could have that there. Now this is a pretty big structure, so I'm pretty excited to get to see it as we go down here along this wall. How cool is this right here? Man, they were up here, weren't they? What a view. Now I'm guessing at one time maybe water ran through that stream down here. They've also got a place over here where now there's a pond that the rancher uses, but I'm sure at one time water ran through here as well. So they had more than one option for the water through here. Now the other one would be right over there on that ridge.
The other one's here.
What are we looking? Here we are, guys. We made it to New Boots after all this time. Now let's look at these shards right here. That is a beauty right there. Look at that piece, these lips. Right here, look at that. The edges, nice size pieces. Looky there, right there. Look at these things. This is I guess I love walls. I love these walls as we go through here. You know, animal sheltered down right there. Let's try to get through this mess because we got a hole we got to get through. Let's get over here out of the wall and let's get up into what they call new boots. Look at this. Wow, look at that wall over there. Look at this place. How incredible is this? This is absolutely unbelievable. I'm gonna stay off these walls as we work our way around through here. Look at this. Really a fabulous place. Now this was a large structure. See a nice wall back there we'll get back to. Look at these walls right here. This is an incredible place. Wow. Look at that. Look at that wall right there hanging off the edge. Look at that. Look how it curves back through here. Look, it runs through here. Another place that we've got an animal that's bedded down right in here. How crazy is that? This was a large structure. That is a beautiful wall right there. Look at that pristine wall. That is incredible. Wow. Look at that. That looks like a mason put that together. You know, 18, 1900s. These don't look like walls that you would expect to see. But you don't get these walls when they're closer to the road because, you know, people get on these walls. And these are mostly dry mason walls. So, I mean, any movement you get into, you're going to be pushing and pulling them in. I mean, remember, these things have been here 600, 700, 800 years. Now, if you want to see a work of art, look at that. Now, what I think about also is this. Look at that. That almost looks like it was mortared in. My God, it is mortared in. Now, what's up with that? I'm not sure. You know, I say that, but it does look like it's mortared in. It doesn't look like dry. Wow, look at that. Now, I'm not sure on that. I'm a little awestruck about what that was and how it was put together. How incredible is it? That looks like a new wall. Now, we're in the middle of nowhere. Now, there is a ranch over here, right? So there is a ranch, but I wouldn't see why they would have had any use for these ruins at that time. I can't see what they would have done with them. So we're going to go through here and see what's laying around. There's a beautiful, just a stone. How smooth that is. That's incredible. So this is new boots. Look at this. Now, this is something that, you know, it's as important to me just to get to come here. Because get to experience another place that is here that I have never seen. And, you know, one thing we decided that was because of the degree of difficulty getting here, you know, let's see everything we can. Because I tell you what, this is not an easy journey here. But it is an unbelievable experience just to be able to say, hey, now I'll pick a stone out on this wall, for example. And what I'll do is look at it. And, you know, a guy was building this wall and he decided that black stone fit perfect in that area, right? And I just find that incredible when they used to build these walls. Look at that rock lump. I mean, the architecture of these ruins is just, you know, it's incredible. That's why we have to make sure that we preserve this stuff because, man, everybody needs to get to see this. This is just incredible. Look at this. You know, get a plane coming across over here and you're just like, oh my gosh. They're looking down here going, wow, this is unbelievable. Then they go, there's people down there. Isn't that wacky? Look at this place. It's that one lonely plane coming across. How incredible is this place? Look at this whole deal. Look at this place. Look at the view they had. And then laying around here is all the remnants of a life that was lived up here on this mesa. And coming across here, and look at that view. You know, I know they had trails going down, structured through here. Now, there is something really funny. That looks like a cave damn near down there. Let's get down over here and take a look if we can see anything over there. Wow, that's pretty interesting. Here's what happens when you're out on the trail. I didn't even feel that. There's definitely a cave structure over there. I don't see anything in it, But the thing about up here is, and I'll tell you, that climb across there would be hairy. If I really thought there was something in there, I would go down. Now, there's one of the signs that I like. A bird of prey was down there. Now, they always love that kind of hill. So how incredible is this whole place down here? Wow. Pretty unbelievable. You know, you're sitting on this cliff, and you know, one thing that I can't get over is, so I'm sitting here and I look down here, and right here, you know, look at this shard. And you know, somebody touched this thing 600-800 years ago. You know, how did it end up over here? Where did it break? Did it wash down? Did somebody, was somebody coming to the edge to take a look just like I am? And did they see it? You know, man, and I really believe with shards, for example, you know, I like to touch the history. It's important though you put them right back. It's important that you put them in the right place. But man, I think it's critical that you sit here, you know, because I'm not the only guy that's ever sat here. Somebody else sat here and contemplated their life just as well as I did. And so how incredible is that? You know, I look at this place and it's just incredible. I mean, it's just unbelievable. You know, I know one thing. If they were looking for a place to protect themselves, this was definitely a beautiful place to do that. Look at this thing. You ain't coming up that hill. And if you do, you ain't getting up. Now look at that. Now, okay, see, this is when I get really intrigued at these places. And I'm just, look at that wall. That's a wall. So they had a wall. So let's just imagine that they had a wall all the way around this, right? Because there's no reason that would, that's stacked. That's not natural. They stacked that wall right there. And I hardly can't believe that, because that meant it went all the way around here too, most likely. So, I mean, I can't imagine somebody coming up that, but then again, you know, if you're hungry and you ain't ate, you might have a reason to climb that hill and risk it. But it's incredible to me that they actually built that wall. And I'm gonna get on the other side of that because I have to see that. That is unreal. Look at that. Now here, as we go through here, look at that chunk right there. That's beautiful. I love the rounded, you know, somebody's hand was on that, that smoothed that out and guided that on, right? How crazy is that? That is a beautiful piece. But I'm gonna get up here to try to figure out what the whole mindset was on these walls. I'll tell you, the walls, construction-wise, are really spectacular. Really incredible to see these pieces up in here. Look at this beauty right there. They got cracked. Look at that. Gonna stick it back in this double piece like it was. Look at there. Now that's a wall right there. Unreal. That is unreal. We're gonna try to flip through here without getting completely stuck. So look at this whole facility as it runs back. Now I gotta get over here real quick and see one thing before we cross. I have to see. I have to see. Oh, you just see these pop out of here. Beautiful red. Wow, how incredible is that? You know, one time they estimated that the ancients, the man would hike 12 miles a day and the women would hike 8. So when you change your world, you understand why your body changes. Things like diabetes change. I mean, all of a sudden, you're a hunter-gatherer, and then all of a sudden, what happens? You know, you stop working out, right? What would happen to us today if we stopped working out? Well, we know what would happen, right? And it was a lot easier when you had to stay in shape than it is, you know, now that you got to force yourself, but there's still the same rewards, that you live a healthier life when you when you take care of yourself. Let's take a look. I'm just trying to figure out, there's kind of like a cave over here, and I really want to see if there is a way to get down there without risk, because there's probably nothing there. But I'd like to see, because something's living in it. Look at this wall over here. How crazy is that? So they had a massive fortress wall around here. There's no doubt that they had all kinds of stuff going on in this location. So, you know, something tells me that I've had way too easy of a hike today, and that I haven't abused myself anywhere close to what I should. And so what I think I'm going to try to do is, and I'm not going to risk it when I get over there, I'm just going to tell you that if it doesn't look feasible, I am not going to go in it. And I can already tell you it doesn't look feasible without ripping my legs completely off my body, because we can tell that there's an animal that lives down there, because there's this trail. Now again, looking at the size and the branches, it's probably, I'm going to guess, maybe a bobcat. I don't think a mountain lion. I might be wrong, but out here would definitely be a place that if there were mountain lions, it would be here. I'm going to try to at least go down another level and take a look, because I really am thinking that, you know, there's something down there that I might need to see. Now let's go down this wash also and just try to figure out what is down here. Is there, you know, just down this wash, so washing down this area right here, you know, there it is. Now I don't know if I can get, if I get down in here, I don't know if I can get into where I want to go, but I would like to at least be able to get a better view of that hole down there. But man, look at this view as we're sitting out here. Tell me this isn't crazy. This is like another level of levels. Now, if we do start to hide down here, we are going to take our time and we're going to go slow and we're going to do it non-stupid like. So let's take a look at what we got and where it goes. Man, if the legs weren't nearly as blown out as they've been, it'd be a lot easier. I've destroyed the knee as well. It's a good place also to look for artifacts down in here. Now that's a no-go. That's no bueno right there. So I'm not even going to risk it. I'm going to take a look at a rock at this wall right here. But I'm not seeing any. That's just not a good plan to go through here. So I'm not going to do it. I might be able to go down one more level though and do it on my butt. Okay, here's an interesting artifact right here. So let's take a look. See this right here? Look at that. Right there. Pull top. So, you know, when you think you're out here in the middle of nowhere and nobody's been here, look at that. Pull top right there. So somebody's been down in this area, or they just threw it off. You know, that's possible just as well. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna gingerly go down here. We're not getting excited about this, because I'm not gonna take a ride if I don't feel comfortable down here. We're gonna say, look at this trail right here. Okay, so this is the animal's trail right here, for sure. This is not a question, right here. You can see how worn this is. Now, I'm gonna throw it out there that we got a cat down here, because it would take something massive to climb this to go to that cave over there. So I'm gonna go about 95% sure that you were dealing with a cat down there. I'm pretty confident. Now there's something down here I'm gonna have to find, check out, because I see something that I'm not gonna get crazy, but we're going to have to take a look once I get a good secure foot base right there. But I didn't bring my gun. So the good news is, if it was a cat, holy shit, that was crazy. So here's what I wanted to see. Look at that piece right there. Is that incredible or what?
That's all that fucking matters.
There it is, right there.
a good movie till he stopped falling.
You know what makes that funny? Is you bastards are laughing your asses off.
Yeah, because you're so fucked up to do that. If you're that fucked up,
I can't help you.
Some cat's got a couple of kittens in there. She's not going to be happy with you.
Well, I don't have a clear way to get in any farther, or I'd get in there. So, well, I think I passed on that. That's about what I fell off of. That's a little closer than I like it to be, man. But you know what? I had to get to that piece down there. It was important. So let's figure out how we're going to climb back up here without killing ourselves. Because, man, it's slick. It's a little hairy, you know, honestly. And all these rocks here are pretty damn slick. So we're going to climb our asses back up here. You know, you don't even realize how slick this is until you get over here. And then remember, I'm also climbing with one hand. We got out of there. Whew. That was close. That's almost too good a movie. I don't like them that close. But it made me feel like I was alive, that's for sure. Whew. Awesome. That was awesome. But that's a cat. There's no doubt in my mind. That trail's way too worn. That's a big animal. And if you want those, look at those shards. That's where you got to go. Just makes you realize that somewhere down there, you know, there's all kinds of stuff washing off this for hundreds of years. You know, look right here. Look at all the different stuff as we go through here. One thing about a place that you haven't seen, you know, you get a lot of shards. There's a lot of material out here that you don't see in a place that's closer up. So, you know, nobody's messed with this stuff. So the cool thing is, as you're wandering through here, always be looking around here because there was activity all around this. When you look at this place on Google Earth, one thing you see is that it's really worn. And it's an incredible location to be able to come to knowing that, you know, all these people live their lives in this area. How incredible is that? You know, these were their homes right here. You know, they lived their lives out. When you think about that, you have to respect the sacredness of these places. And that old can, it doesn't necessarily mean that that was the pot hunter. Maybe it was a rancher out here. You know, back in the day, nobody believed in, you know, trash collection for some crazy reason, but that is what it was. So you look through here and you just wander through this place. It's really incredible to see the stuff that's here. And, you know, just to be able to go experience this place is a pretty unbelievable experience. You know, it really is. Get to walk through these people's houses. I mean, look at all the stuff that's here. There's all, you see all kinds of different pieces. And then you look at, it's a nice piece right there. Look at that. Wow, look at that piece. It's incredible as you walk through here. Push it back down here. There's another piece of it right there, one of it. That's just spectacular as you walk through here. This is the nice thing about getting one that's way out here. I mean, there's stuff here all over. Nice thick piece right there. How incredible is this? So they had all these houses that lived through here, and we know they had a massive wall around it. And it's fun just to look through here. You know, especially if you just like to, you know, look around and experience the life that they lived. The walls, these walls that they lived their lives in. And you see them and you think about, I always think about, man, how good the structures were that they built. Now that's kind of neat too, because you kind of got this interior wall that comes through here that's pretty incredible. It's a little bit different. Look at this one we just stumbled on right there. You know, this stuff's all over. There's shards everywhere here. I mean, if you just wanted to keep looking, you know, look at this right here. Look at all these clean shards in the spot. You know, as you go through here, it's just incredible just to look at all the stuff. And I'm wanting to try to make sure that I see everything because, you know, this is the kind of a location that you don't get a chance to really, you know, you can get back to, but it's not going to be easy. So you really want to make sure. Look how long and across this is. Just an incredible place. But why we got the heat down and why we, because we may not get over here for a long time. I want to see if we can't get to what we call the in-between. And I've actually got the GPS on it right now, and we've got coordinates to it. So I'm going to take a journey over to the... and you know, there's still shards all over. You know, all over this area. It's just incredible. I'm going to take a walk over in this area. It says I've got five-tenths half mile. But even when we get out here, I'm really curious to see what I find away from the main Pueblo. Look at that rabbit, just scared the hell out of me. He's an awful friendly guy, considering he's got a pretty damn big predator down there. Let's journey through here. Man, I hope you guys are having a great time. I tell you what, this is a pretty incredible place. Now, our other location is over there. Probably not going to get to that today, but we are going to get to a secondary location. I'm still running into shards this far out. You know, so there's shards all over this place. I mean, I'm seeing them as I walk through the grass all over. Look at these prominent animal trails. That's kind of cool, actually. See, I'm getting shards even this far. So there's what we're looking at right there. If you can see that, I don't know if you can or not. It says I need to go right that way. I love this thing. Damn, that hurt. Ooh. Couldn't see that cactus there. It went right in my leg. I didn't be paying more attention. Now, that shouldn't have happened. Should be looking at that. You know, what's funny is, you know, most of the hiking over here was extremely easy. Extremely easy. And then... you take this side trip. Let's just be a lesson to everybody. It's always a side trip. It's always a secondary hike. You got the primary, got secondary. I got needles in my legs. But that. That kind of hurt. Oh, the camera's still going. It sounded like it was empty. Maybe it is. If it is, it's going to shut down pretty quick. We're going to go to this. They just called me and said, come back, man. We've got some massive petroglyphs that I'm definitely going to want to see.